my loves, and welcome back to my channel. I'm Ashley K. If you didn't know, there you go. Welcome back, my loves. I am back. I have been missing. I know. I am sorry. I haven't dropped the video in weeks, and that's because I am going through stuff personally, okay? And I'm talking mentally. I am going through things. I am going through family issues. I am going through relationship issues, love. I'm going through a lot, and I just come to update you all, okay? Because 2020 has been a roller coaster, okay? It has been a roller coaster for me so far. It's been a very challenging year, okay? Coming into the year, I just knew it was going to be a great year. Like, I knew it was going to be a great year. Like, coming in, you know, I didn't know what to expect, but I had my mind set on so many things, okay? As far as financially, as far as relationship, as far as my future plans, I had everything planned out into my head of how I wanted things to go this year. And nothing is going the way I expected. I don't know if it's just this COVID situation, if it's all that. I don't know, guys. I don't know. But I come to give you all an update on me and what I have going on. And just to talk to y'all, you know, to let you know, during this time, you're not alone, okay? Because I know sometimes I do feel very alone, and I'm someone who has, I've had to train myself to be alone. I am someone, I don't like being alone. I don't, and that's one reason I'm always, like, growing up, I always have friends. My relationships always last at least 2 to 3 years, and that's simply because I hold on. I don't know how to let go, even when I know when to let go. Like, I know, like, Ashley, it's time to let this friendship go. It's time to let this relationship go. But I hold on because I don't like being by myself. But leading up to 2020, I had time to be by myself, you know. Even though I was, okay, so let's rewind back to, like, November of 2019, that's when I really started being alone. That's when it really hit me, like, you know, I really don't have anyone. Like, out here in Charlotte, I really don't have any friends. I have one person who I am mad close with, but, you know, things are rocky between us, so it's like, how can I explain it? If they're not around, then I'm just alone. Like, I'm just alone, and I had to learn to be alone. And once I did learn to be alone, I was comfortable with it. So, but anyways, I had to learn to be alone, and once I was comfortable with being alone, that's what I wanted to be. But come 2020, with all this quarantine and the year just being crazy off bat, it was just like, I need somebody, I need friends. Like, if you don't tell me to sit in the house, I will sit in the house. But once they're telling us to sit in the house, I don't want to sit in the house no more. I want friends. I want to go out. I want to do something. Like, I had spent, like, the whole end of 2019 losing weight, trying to get healthy, you know, getting myself together, because I truly lost myself in 2019. Like, truly lost myself, and at the end, that's like when I started to find myself again, and it's like, I done lost weight, you know, I look good. Not to just say that, but, you know, I feel better about myself. I'm more confident. Like, before, I was so lost, I could feel myself going into depression and just, like, out of my body. Like, I wasn't Ashley. I don't know who the hell I was, but I didn't feel like myself, so that's why I started to lose weight. I got on my YouTube consistently. Like, I did things that actually made me happy. Like, I had to figure out what makes me happy. How can I make myself happy alone? Because if I don't have this person here, you know, what am I going to do? What am I going to turn to? All I have to turn to is myself. So I had to come up with ways to keep myself happy. And my weight was something that I definitely struggled with, you know. Never really mentioned it to anyone, but that was something that was like, I have to lose weight. Like, I had never been like as big as I was, even though I knew it was from, you know, being so happy in a relationship, being so comfortable. But it's like, that's me letting myself go. Like, I let myself go. And it's like, I had to come back. I had to come back to reality. I'm like, okay, you're by yourself now. You have a ton of time on your hands. You have time to get yourself together. Like, I had so much time to get myself together. So I did all of this at the end of 2019. Come 2020, you know, the first month of 2020, it was cool. January was cool. That was a cool month. I had a great New Year's. It was cool, okay? The ball was on in my court, okay? It was rolling in my court. I had a good New Year's in Atlanta. I came back, switched the first shift, you know, done with school. Everything was good. Everything was good. Then it comes to a few months later and we have COVID going on. It's like, what? So it just starts freaking everyone out. On top of that, okay, we can't go anywhere. And, you know, I've hooked back up with old friends. And it's like, now we can't go nowhere, girl. We can't do anything, you know. And I've come out of my shell. Not to say, you know, I'm just some shy person or whatever. But I had came out. I'm sorry, guys. It's my watch. I had came out of my shell to the point where it's like, I'm gonna live, you know. I've been in this dark place, this dark, you know, my mind has just been at a very dark space and place for a long time. So it's just like, and I feel, you know, not even that I feel like myself again. I feel 10 times better than myself again, you know, and I'm still young. So it's just like, I don't know, y'all, but a lot happened. So with all of that being said, I done did all this work. Okay, I done did all this work and it's like I just fell off the wagon because it was a reason I distanced myself from the people that, you know, I started talking to again. Came 2020, it was a reason, okay? It was always a reason behind the reason I didn't talk to the people anymore. And I don't know what in my right mind had me think like, you know, kick it with these people. Ashley, these are the same people that you cut off years ago. For good reasons. And now, why, what are you doing? And it's like, it took me to what? It was like April, beginning of May is when I realized, like, what the hell are you doing? Like, I really realized, like, why? Like, you were doing so good. You were doing so good, but you didn't want to be alone. And the person that you do, you know, well, we ain't going to get into that yet. But because I didn't want to be alone, but I just want to be with people that I'm familiar with, you know, at the time, I ended up back with these people who are a bad influence on me. Like, I'm in such a great space, and I'm just going to associate myself with these people that's just going to get me off track, which they did. And, you know, not to say these are terrible people, okay? Not to knock my people, because, you know, we grew up together. Nothing wrong with them. It's just where I'm at in my life and where they are is just like we're not compatible for each other. Like, you make me do less than I am, if you get what I'm saying. Like, I could be doing so great and I start hanging with this crowd and it's like, I'm just back down. Like, I don't know how to explain it, y'all, but it's like I can be up here and I hang with them and I'm back down here at their level. And it's like you have to associate yourself with people that are on your level. And me knowing this, but not thinking, because the year is just already on some bullshit, so I might as well entertain the bullshit. So excuse my language, but that's literally how I was coming. It was just like I got into this mindset of just, I don't give a fuck. Excuse my language, y'all. But that's the type of person I am when I am associated with these people. It's just like they bring out the side of me that just doesn't care. Like, and for so long I had got away from that all of that. Like, I've been out of that state of mind. I've been out of that type of person for what, 4 years now, and it's like as soon as I bring them people back around, it shows you like why you shouldn't have people around. Why people are taken out of your life. You know, people come in your life for a reason. They came in my life to, back then, you know, we was having fun, we were young. I could have this, you know, I don't care attitude because I didn't have anything to lose back then. But it's like, you can't come in my life now because I have too much to lose, okay? I have too much to lose. I have too much in store for myself. And it's like, we all make mistakes. We're all still learning. And that's my issue that I'm dealing with right now, because it's like I allowed them back in my life knowing I shouldn't have. And I don't want to say they messed up my life. I can't blame it on anyone but myself because I allowed it. So it's like right now I'm trying to put the pieces back together. I'm trying to, you know, my focus isn't on anyone else. You know, I know I've upset people, I've hurt feelings, and it's just like, I'm sorry, but if only you knew the backstory to why I do what I do. Like, there's a reason for everything. Every reaction is, you know, brought upon by an action. So something happens, I'm going to react to it. So I know there's a lot of people, you know, for years, years after high school, I didn't associate myself with anyone. I didn't have friends. I went off to college. I had like, what, two friends that no longer went to college with me after what, like 2-3 years, they were gone. So it's like, those were my closest two friends, and once they left, I didn't have anyone but my boyfriend at the time. So it's like, okay, I have this person. I'm already someone who don't, you know, associate with anyone, especially not back home. Like, the people back home, I like to keep the people back home. Like, that's the type of person I am. If you're back home in my hometown, I really don't like to associate with you. But that was my issue here in 2020, and it's like, the same, and it's so crazy. I graduated in 2016. And 2016 was my year of turn up, should we say, okay? 2016, I turned up. And it's like, I don't know what it was, but something in me, like, how old was I back then? Like 17, 18? That turn up, Ashley, was trying to come back. It's like that part of me was trying to come back and turn up in 2020. And it's like, no, like, we're not 17, 18 no more where you can just be wild. Like, I have things to lose nowadays. Like, I really have stuff to lose. And it's like, I had to break down these things to, you know, friends that I had, and we, you know, reunited. And it's like, I had to break this down to them. And it's like, people don't like to understand it. People don't like to be understanding, like, okay, I get it. Like, I'm not doing shit with my life and you are, and I'm not trying to ruin what you got going on. So I'll just go my way and you go your way. It has to be a fuss. It has to be a fuss. I tried cutting off, you know, one person, and it's just like, I feel like we've really burnt the bridge, you know? Because this time I really had to, like, truly cut you off. Like, you truly have to go this time. Whereas in 2016, I was just going off to college, so we can't talk anymore. Like, I'm not about to be here, so you're going to have to find somebody else. But with this certain friend, this time it's like, I just had to let it be known, like, you got to go. Because you messing up my footsteps. Like, you messing up my order. Like, I had plans, and it's like the devil been on me, okay? Because I was doing so good for what, 4 years, and it's like the devil came in and he challenged me. This has been a challenging year for me. He has challenged me. I have made mistakes that I wish I could go back in time and take it back, you know, But we live and we learn. I am young. I am not regretting anything I have done this year because it'll only get better. I am still a work in progress. I am still maturing into a, you know, young woman. There's a lot, you know. At least, you know, one thing I am proud of is that I can acknowledge. I am not oblivious or blind to what I do or, you know, what's going on around me. Like, I'm very aware, even in the midst of it going on. But it's like, I don't know. But I'm just very glad that I am aware now. You know, back then, I would just do it and not care about the consequences or try to figure out, like, why is this happening? But now it's like, he wanted to get me off my A game. He really wanted to get me off my A game. And he came in and he disturbed the peace because I had a lot of peace going on. He brought in some demons. He brought in some past skeletons that didn't need to be out. Like, he really brought in destruction. And it's just like, I can't even be mad at anyone though, because I know right from wrong. I know that I was doing wrong, but I seen it as, you know, catching up and having fun. But it's like, that's not that fun. I'm not that same girl. I'm not her. And it's like, I have one side of me that's just like, have the fun, you're young. And then another side is like, no, like, you got too much to lose. You done came too far to try to mess up what you got going on. They gotta go. So I had to let people go. And so after, you know, my big old altercation, my argument, everything I had going on with the particular, you know, friends that I had, it's just like, I'm back at just being alone, you know. I have no issue with cutting people off. That's one thing about me. I have no issue with cutting people off. And when I cut people off, you probably never hear from me again. Like, there's people to this day that I've cut off and you can't even get a hate from me. Cause that's just the type of person I am. Like, it's not me holding a grudge, but it's just like, you're no good for me. Like, your energy is no good for me. And if I have you around me and if you just interrupt me like that, like, if you are someone who I can allow to get me out of my character, allow to take me to a place that I don't need to be, take me to a person I used to be, I can't have you around me. Okay? I can't have you around me. And that's the issue. It's just like, what am I doing? What am I doing? And, you know, I would sit there like, it's just a little fun. I'll just jump back on the wagon. You can't keep doing that. I don't want my life to be a revolving door. Okay, every 4 years, I'm back at this old Ashley. I'm trying to break this cycle. So right now, I've been to myself. People see me as being nonchalant, just not caring about anything and just letting everything be. But it's just like, I care more about my peace of mind. I'm not going to entertain anything that's not benefiting me. Like, if you're not here to benefit me or help me, you know, because I understand that I do truly need help. Not saying like I need help, which nothing is wrong with that. Anyone who feels they need to get help, I feel get it. But I do need help, and it's like, only I can help myself. That's where I'm at. I don't want to go talk to nobody and discuss my issues, because it's me. I need to dig deeper within myself to figure out what is it that's holding me back to these people. Like, what is it? What was it that had me actually, you know, get in contact with these people and actually link with these? Like, what was it? So that's where I'm digging at right now. Like, I'm not gonna let it eat me up, nothing like that, but it's just like, I have to get to the root of things, because I have things like I mentioned, family issues really going on right now. And it's just like, I'll get more into this later in my channel, you know, as we progress. But, you know, I have issues with my father that I don't really speak too much on. There's probably no one I have ever spoke about this situation to, and it's just simply like that causes a lot of issues in my friendships, and most certainly in my relationships. And I feel like for a lot of women, like, some of the root of the issues that we cause in relationships is from daddy issues. But I don't want to be the stereotypical, you know, daddy issue girl. Like, I don't want to be that. So I don't talk about my issues that I have with my father. But that is something that I'm trying to work on. You know, I ignored it for so long. I was just like, I don't care. And it's like, that's hit me too. And it's just like, you care. Like, everything is just hitting me. Everything that I try to just put behind me and move on from is just coming to the surface. And it's like, just 2020 is just a reflection of me. 2020 is really the time where I have to get to the core of things in order for me to progress in networking for the rest of my life. If I want a long-lasting relationship, if I want friendships that really, like, mean something to me to last, I have to get to the core of my personal issues. So that's why I told myself I was taking 2020 out to just be alone, to just be by myself. And I was doing so good. And it's like, I got caught up. I lost sight of the plan. Okay. And that's the thing, in 2020, you have to keep the vision. You can't lose that 2020 vision. You have to keep it there. And I lost it. Okay. But I'm back here, guys, and I just wanted to come update you all, let you know, you know, if you feel like you done lost track in this year, do not beat yourself up. We are young, we are human, we make mistakes, okay? We backtrack at times, but long as you can catch yourself and don't let it continue, I feel like that's the best part about growth. I am still growing, okay? I am 10 times better than the woman I was 12 months ago. 10 times better. I am more vocal. I am more open. Okay. I used to be this closed book. No one would know anything about me. I really used to be a closed book. And it's just like, I'm more open. I'm here for advice to anyone, you know, if it doesn't disrupt me or, you know, mess up anything I have going on, I'm here to help people. That's the thing. I don't have any issue with helping anyone, but it's just like, don't come into my life wanting my help, taking from all my energy. And that's the thing, when people come around, it's like they take from all my energy and they just put me at this low point, and I allow it. That's the crazy part about it. Like, I really allow people to take away from my energy, and I just get so disgusted when I think about it, because it's like, Ashley, you are more than that. Like, you are better than that. But I am not going to beat myself up. Right now is what? September? Is it September? Yes, it is September, guys. And my YouTube, I couldn't really do much with my YouTube because I wasn't in the right headspace. I'm out here with people running around doing shit I'm not supposed to be doing. And it's just like, y'all taking away from my time that I'm supposed to be at home chilling, making my YouTube videos, and I'm sitting here BSing with y'all. What is y'all doing? Like, I can see if we all on the same page. Like, you got your shit going on, I got mine going on. Y'all, please excuse my language in this video. I'm just keeping as real and as raw with y'all as possible. But it's just like, I've allowed people to take away from my energy this year, and it's just like, I can't let it happen no more. I can't let it happen anymore. So I'm back at the drawing board. Not really at the drawing board, but I'm back at square B. I'm not going to say, my bad. A, okay, I'm at B now. I will be sure to get back on these videos because I have a lot in store for you all. The year is almost up, and I have a great big surprise for you all come woman, every move that I make from this point forward is for me. And I'm going to be very selfish with me for the rest of this year. You know, like I've mentioned, like, I know I've hurt people and I've done a lot of things, but it's just like, you got to accept that I am human. I am making mistakes. There's like, and I'm not here for a pity party. I'm not here to just blame my actions on everyone else. Like, I did this because these people were around, because I know better. But it's just like, you have to understand where I come from. Like, you really have to understand me to understand why I do what I do, why I am like I am. But yeah, that is my update. I've been gone for a minute, but I'm back. I feel like I had to take me a break. I'm not on social media at this time. I got off of social media. Well, I still have my Instagram, and that's just because everyone from my YouTube finds me on my Instagram. That's where I post my pictures, so you guys can stay updated on me and everything like that. But as far as Snapchat, Facebook, Twitter, all of that, I'm not on there. I'm going to take the rest of this year just to be away from the social media, just try to put my focus into here. Also, guys, I had started a second job, so that had took away a lot of time that I had for YouTube, but it's just like, I need more money to support my dream. So it's just like, I have to get a second job, like, because I have plans. And it's like that I had got a second job after I realized, like, okay, you don't like to be alone. You want to sit here and be out with these people. I don't want to keep saying it like they're just terrible people, but you want to hang out with these people who are still in their 17, 18-year-old mindset. And it's just like, what could you be doing to benefit you, Ashley? And it's like, working. Like, I just have to work. Like, that's what keeps me going. Like, that's what keeps me sane. It's working. I have to work. So I got a second job after everything I was going through. I was just like, you know what? Just to get back on track, just to get my mind, just to reset my mind, let me get a second job. Because I won't have time for nobody. I won't have time to sit here and worry about being alone. I won't have time for anything but work. So I had got me a second job. Working, you know, nights. So it's just like, I can't make a YouTube video. And when I do feel like making a YouTube video, I'm too tired. So it's just like, what? Like, I can't win for losing. So yeah, I did let my second job go, but I do have another second job. But this job is more, you know, easy. It's exactly the same thing as my first job. So I know I will have more than enough energy to make videos for you all. But I did want to come and update you guys and let you know I'm going through it. I'm going through it, but I'm getting through it. That's the best part about it. I am going through it, but I'm getting through it. And I know I have some people that are judging me. I have people that are looking down on me, but long as I know my heart, I know my mind, like, I know what's truly going on. I don't have to explain anything to anyone. I owe all of that to myself. I owe an explanation to myself. I owe me being the best I can be to myself. And that's what I am doing. So I've, you know, put my guard back up, because that was one thing I did let my guard down. It's like, you don't do that, Ashley. You don't do that. I'm not known for letting my guard down. School. I don't want to say I was a wild child, but I had my fun. But once I got to college and I started growing and maturing, it was just like, I don't have time for this. And then I slipped, came 2020, because 2020 has just been stressful and I just needed some stress-free experience. I feel like that's what it was. I just wanted some stress-free experience in my life. And it's like, you got it and you messed up. You got it and you took advantage of it. So now look. Now you have to suffer the consequences, but it's life. You live and you learn, and I've learned, and I'm moving on from it. It'll only make me a greater person. That's the best part about it. Mistakes only make you more amazing. Like, so I soak in all my mistakes, and it's like, okay, what am I going to do better next time? What am I not going to do next time? Okay? And what am I going to do next time to avoid any of this? So, here I am. I love you guys so much. I will have a video coming for you all. I kind of got on here with a hat on, everything. I will have this hat posted to my website. See, my website was supposed to go up September 1st, and there's a lot with that. I'll make a separate video about that, but a lot happened with that, and it was just like, now you don't even want to make my website because you mad. But yeah, guys, I have a lot coming for y'all. Stick around. Thank you so much for the support. If you made it this far in the video, give it a thumbs up. If you are someone who you know is going through a lot in this year, this has been a crazy year, guys. I did not mean to make this video this long. Obviously, I had a lot to talk about, and I owe y'all an explanation. Look, I was just saying I don't owe nobody an explanation. I owe y'all an explanation. So I'm giving to y'all. But this year has been very trying, and it's like, maybe that's what I needed. I needed a little challenge. I needed something to challenge me, because I've been getting the easy task, and it's just been something I can accept. And it's just like, this one was just like really a reflection. Like, I really had to reflect on me and think, like, what are you doing? Like, I really had to question myself, and I never questioned myself. I'm never someone that's like, Ashley, what are you doing? Because I'm always on top of it. But that devil come in and he get up on your feet and he lift you and he's just like, okay, I got your attention. And it's like, Once I realized, like, who I was playing ball with, it was just like, We're not finna do this. But yeah, guys, I will see y'all in my next video. Thank you so much. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Okay? Turn on your notification bell so you know every time I post, and I will be posting. Okay? Consistently. I'm back, guys. I'm back. I'll see y'all in my next video.